Welcome back, everybody, to Minor League Esports. This Premier League game between the Bulls and the Hurricanes. My name is Sleegy. Joined with me is ZB, and we've got a match up for you here. Let's go ahead and take a look at this playoff picture bracket as we get ready to get started with this match. You'll see the Bulls and the Hurricanes down here fighting for that conference final. And an update that came in as well. Hive 3-1 the Sharks. So that's going to impact the bracket. They'll go up against whoever wins the Foxes and the Jets game. But getting ready to get started, we'll see who can take it with the Bulls and the Hurricanes. But first, let's roll a map intro for this week's map, Utopia Coliseum Dusk. And we're off with this game of the Bulls and the Hurricanes, and it's set up to be a great one.
Yeah, this is a rematch of week one. Bulls took this first matchup 3-2, but that game did not include Foms or Iguan, and Foms on cue puts that one in. If you have been following the Premier League, you know that Foms has been a dominant player, has been a popular choice in Fantasy League, as he always racks up the MVPR, and he shows it there with his 67th goal of the season. Can you believe that?
Absolutely incredible from him, and just what an effort to start out this game from the Bulls. Gonna go up 1-0 early as Flom's trying to get a second touch on this one off the post. Oh, it goes just wide, and Rainbow with the follow-up, but a save from Iguan, gonna keep it out.
Ooh. Yeah, great job by the Hurricanes. They're definitely a good scoring opportunity for the Bulls. So just to kind of set this one up, Bulls in the red, they have Flom's and Rainbow Noms, and Hurricanes will be in the green, Peebs and Iguan, and there's Rainbow Noms. Gonna do it himself, just dribble that one into goal. I know that Flom's got demo, but it didn't matter. Rainbow just took that ball from the side and demoed it straight in. I kind of looked away, didn't see where the Hurricanes were, but Bulls finding themselves on top early.
And what an amazing opening so far for the Bulls in this one. Building up a lot of momentum as Flom's going to get demoed there. And I'm going to take this opportunity to remind everyone that today's series is sponsored by PowerA, creators of innovative gaming accessory products that enhance the world's best video game and mobile technology experience. Also, I want to mention Balls Guarana, our replay sponsor, and the best place you can get ultra-caffeinated soda. Each Balls drink is crisp and infused with naturally energizing Guarana berry. You can find out more about both of these sponsors over at mlesports.gg/sponsors. As we get ready to continue on in this game, a pinch from Rainbow Nom is going to go just wide.
Yeah, kind of a different game in the past 45 seconds or so that... To start off, Bulls were on the 100% attack to start, and now they've kind of been content with just kind of passing this one back and forth. This ball has kind of really stayed in the midfield, neither team really with a scoring opportunity. Bulls up two, I think they would want to attack just a little bit more, but they might be honestly comfortable just with slowing this down and waiting until the opportunity presents itself.
And Rainbow Nom's gonna pick that up in the midfield. A good touch there, gonna keep it out, but Flom's with the follow-up. Rainbow had opted to fall back a little bit, so wasn't quite in a position to capitalize. Gets the back touch, it's gonna go back in the middle. Gonna go over Rainbow, but Flom's trying to get set up as Rainbow gets a touch. Can he get the follow-up? Yes! Oh, it fires in the mid, but Flom's not quick enough to respond.
Yeah, even, so we just did a Champ League game, and even just jumping up one division, both teams are very comfortable with all of their mechanics, so you really just have to keep working until you can find that one mistake or the one hole in the defense. Luckily for the Bulls, they've been able to do that early, so they're in a very comfortable spot. There's another good shot by Flams, but Peeves just puts it off to the side. Bulls are finding themselves in a good spot. I feel like they're comfortable and are really just going to try to ride this one out and try to find a game one victory, and they're comfortable with this 2-0 lead.
Absolutely. Wanting to maintain that lead throughout is Peeves. Going to get a shot on the goal. It's going to go just off the bar. The follow-up from Iguan wide. And that was a huge opportunity for the Hurricane to try and minimize on this Bulls lead, just not able to capitalize.
Yeah, you're going to have to really take advantage of the scoring opportunities. Enough time, obviously, but, you know, time's ticking away, so they're going to need to find an attack quick.
Oh, and a shot here. Going to get just wide. Thanks to that touch from Iguan. Follow-up going back in. Ooh, Flom's doing a good job of staying on top of it. Bulls here in a good position. Going to come off the ceiling. Can Flom's get up to it? Oh, it's just wide, and that was an opportunity for the Bulls to go up by three.
Yeah, Bulls keep pushing here. Hurricanes haven't really had a chance to score. They do there, but there's Flom. Again, on the offensive and defensive side of the ball, a double commit, but they might be okay because Flams gets redirected by his teammate straight into goal. Bulls kind of doing everything right, not unlike the Blizzards that we saw earlier.
Oh, and Peeves almost able to get to it, but a great touch from the Bulls keeps it out. And the 40 seconds remain in this one. Hurricane still down by two as Iguan going to try and dribble that in. Can't follow it before the Bulls get there, and time really starting to run out. Noms up for this, gonna send it on the goal, and a great save from Iguan to keep it out. Rainbow Noms can't get the follow-up, and that double commit could lead to a goal from the Hurricanes, and it does.
Wow, great play first to make the pinch save and goal, recover and bump it forward. Peeves there, just in case he needs it, but Iguan doesn't need it, so he scored with just enough time. 15 seconds, obviously enough time to get the job done.
Let's see if the Hurricanes can pull it off and push it into overtime. Rainbow Noms up for this one. It's going to get sent to the left wall. 8 seconds remaining as Peeves having to get around, tries to get the pinch, but it's not hard enough. Flom's up for this now. Double commit from the Hurricanes could be deadly as that ball going to get spiked. Bulls taking game one in a close one that came down to the wire.
Yeah, really good game from the Bulls there. We didn't really stakes. Just that one double commit that led to a wise down play. They got up by those two goals early, and I kind of felt like they may have just sat back and played it safe. A team like the Hurricanes, who's certainly capable of scoring, that might come back to cost them if in the future they find themselves with a lead and just deciding to sit back. Hurricanes show that they're able to take advantage of that. But props to the Hurricanes being able to maintain a competitive game. I know Bulls are kind of the favorite, especially on this side of the bracket after the dominating season they have. So Hurricanes probably still have to feel good about that performance and feel like they can keep up the work there.
And they kept it real close too. Looking at the stats, they had each team 5 saves. Bulls with 9 shots against the Hurricanes 7, keeping it close. That one goal really being the difference maker. Hurricanes had a couple of opportunities to equalize or get in a better position to, and just not capitalizing on the plays that were presented before them. But still, a lot of time left in this series. They can take it back in game two and really start to push it as we get ready to get kicked off here.
Yeah, as I always say, trust the process. Trust what has worked for you this entire season. Hurricanes obviously played well enough to qualify for the playoffs. So just trust your game plan. Trust your teammates. Keep playing. If Bulls play as well as they're capable, they're going to be a tough team to beat. But I know Hurricanes can match their level of play.
And we're off here in game two. Rainbow Noms going to pick it up. Sends it over. But a good save there from Iguan. He reads it fantastically and keeps it scoreless early in this one.
Yeah, I don't know if anything Noms did was were there. Such a great job of shadowing and doing a good job of getting himself in position. Iguan is up, but that's kind of a misplay. He wasn't able to touch it. Luckily, Peeves was sending right under him. Rainbow Noms gets up. Kind of a hectic start to this one.
And Flams going up off the wall, going to send it down the field. Aguan gets a good touch, but it's not going to matter as Rainbow Nom's going to pick it up, tries to get it past, but he's not quite able. But Flom's still there, keeping it in the Hurricanes' half. Aguan doing a good job of getting possession, and this ball going back and forth, floating in a dangerous spot here. Can Flom's get back to it? Doesn't quite have the speed, but gets the block off the wall. And this game really heating up between these two teams now.
Yeah, kind of had a couple instances there where that ball was just kind of being boomed back and forth by Noms, but Peeve saved it. Kind of a different feel to this game. A lot less team possession and a lot more just ping-ponging the ball back and forth. But I think Hurricanes might kind of want that. Take away the possession game from Bulls and just see if they can beat them over the top.
Oh, and a good shot from Peeves. Gonna be picked up from Flom. Gets a touch over. Peeves not quite able to respond, but Aguan is there in the corner. Rainbow Noms gets a good touch over, but the follow-up from Aguan gonna be saved by Floms. Aguan still following it here, has a chance to get it centered. His teammate a little bit too far back, but that might be good as it gets sent towards him, but Peeves just not able to get the touch, goes right over.
Something I've been really impressed by both teams on the defensive side of the ball. They've had good touches and good positioning. Neither team able to have a good scoring opportunity, to say the least. Only 3 shots on goal, and that's mostly because teams have been rotating so quickly to prevent that. I kind of feel like it's either going to be a case of where the first team that scores, they're going to feel confident enough just to hold this one out, or it may just open the floodgates. So we're about at the halfway mark. No one scored yet. Gonna kind of be interesting to see how this one ends.
We are seeing some great team play, though, coming from both teams here. Peeves gonna pick that one up in midfield, tries to send it down, but intercepted by Rainbow. Aguan taking it up the wall, can't get the follow-up touch. Flom's rushing in to get to it, slows down a bit to gain some control, but it's a little bit too slow as Aguan gonna get it, the ball off of him. Peeves now trying to follow. Sends it off the backboard. Oh no, an unfortunate side flip from Aguan. Gonna mean he's out of position to receive that pass.
Yeah, more of the same. Just good rotations on defense. I've noticed Aguan, I don't know if he went with a red accent color trying to throw off the other team. I don't know if that's confusing them. It didn't confuse Rainbow Nom as that touch goes off the backboard. As I talked about Aguan, I think he just had a misplay on the wall, not able to get the touch to send it the other way. Rainbow Nom's getting up and burying it into the goal. Finally, our first goal more than 3 minutes into the game, and Bulls have find themselves with another lead.
Yeah, it looked like Aguan just maybe got caught up a little bit on the post, lost all his momentum and wasn't able to get around, and that led to the goal as Peeves gonna get a good block. Aguan able to pick it up. Flom's there. Back to the Hurricanes. Peeve misses an opportunity for a shot on the goal. Flom's now, trying to get the ground pinch back, not quite able. And that's gonna be Flom sending it back downfield.
Yeah, Hurricane are really gonna have to find a way. I don't know if you're gonna be able to do it conventionally against how this Bulls defense, and there's Flom's again, just flying around, making sure that any ball comes across the net is cleared away. Great touch there. He knew that the defender was back checking, but not quite able to get there fast enough. So he just slow plays this and pops it up straight over him. 2 goals is even going to be more difficult for the Hurricanes.
And Peeves really stretching himself to try and get there in time, just unable to get the height, to get the touch, and now going to find themselves in a 2-goal deficit with less than a minute to go. We saw it happen last game, though. They got 1 goal back with 15 seconds remaining. Let's see if they can do it again as Aguan going to 50 Rainbow, gets flipped upside down and and is able to regain control.
Yeah, it's going to take something real special from the Hurricanes. I know they're doing such a good job of pressuring the ball. And there it is again. Rainbow just rotating to the ball so fast, is realizing that Peeves isn't going to get a touch, puts it in a position where Aguan isn't able to get the touch. He just follows it and buries it. Bulls have to believe that they are well on their way to a 2-0 series lead.
And unless the Hurricane can score pretty much immediately, this game gonna be going to the Bulls again. Aguan trying to go for a ceiling shot there, but gets stolen from Flom's. who gets a demo on Peeves. Bull trying to secure the final seconds of this game, and too little time left for the Hurricane to come back. Bull is going to be taking game two, only one away from winning the series as Peeves gets that final save.
Yeah, just like in the first game on stream, the results that we're seeing in the game is kind of, I think, people expected. We actually have the playoff prediction data. We're going to wait for this one just to touch the ground. Bulls with another dominating performance. The bracket prediction results are in. 88% of MLE users that submitted a bracket predicted the Bulls to win this matchup, and they obviously knew what they were doing when they predicted that, because Bulls have been dominating. Rainbow Noms higher on the score line there. I know Flomps doesn't matter how it's done, he just wants to win, but Hurricanes not able to shore up things defensively and not able to turn that into offensive opportunities. They found themselves in a real bad spot here. Bulls up 2-0.
And the Bulls keeping the pressure alive all game long. 7 shots on target, 3 go in. What happens to the other 4, you might say? Well, they were saved by the Hurricanes. Excellent accuracy coming from the Bulls, and the Hurricanes now finding themselves on the ropes in this series. 1 game away from their season coming to a close, but the Bulls on the cusp of moving to the conference finals.
Yeah, I'd be scared anytime I have to play a player like Flom. Rainbow, not great job supporting him. Hurricanes might just want to try being crazy. Just play as fast as you can. Trust your ability to make those touches to put the Bulls in a bad spot. But if the Bulls play in game 3 anything like they do in games 1 and 2, they are going to be tough to beat. But I'm excited to see how this one turns out.
Well, we're only a moment away from this one kicking off. The Bulls again in game 3 of this best of 5, only one away from securing that conference final. Let's see if the Hurricanes can start a comeback, as Iguan going to start trying to send this downfield. Flom's to follow, and then Peeps to clear it off to the side.
Yeah, while we're here, don't forget to enter in the power. And also, if you find any plays that you think be a play of the week, go ahead and clip those and submit them in the Discord or on Twitter. The winner of player of the week gets a full case of balls, which I know is delicious. Rainbow Noms with another good touch on goal. Bulls so far able to get some good shots on target and obviously rotating back on defense. Much of the same for the Bulls so far.
And Peeb's gonna pick this one up. But speaking of those, that balls for the play of the week, they are delicious. I tried some after joining the league. Was not at all disappointed. But anyways, back to the game here. Iguan trying to slow it down a little bit, able to get a touch off the wall. Flom gonna send it up. My bad. Don't know what happened there. But Peeps trying to get the follow up off the wall, not quite able to get there in time. Iguan now trying to get it back center, but he's gonna get beat to it by Rainbow Noms.
Yeah, Hurricane's doing a better job of keeping the ball in the Bulls half, but just not able to get that next touch. The ball's kind of stuck in the corner here, and you see this a lot in Rocket League, where the ball will just sit in the corner and the team just kind of bang it back and forth. You got to find a way to either get it center or get it over the opponent or something, because what they were doing right there to just keep sending it into the corner and up the wall just not working. So I'd like to see them try to get at least a little more creative.
And now Flom's got to get up to it from Iguan, able to get a touch. Ooh, wins that 50 on Rainbow Noms. Ball in a dangerous spot here, but Flom's able to get back to it in time to clear it out of danger. Rainbow Noms now with the follow-up, able to get it past one. Ball in a good spot here, but Peeves able to get there in time to keep it from going in the center.
Yeah, Flom's was almost there to send it back in, but just had a missed touch there. The thing I've noticed about the Bulls that are different than the Hurricanes is rotation a little bit faster, so when someone sends one in, a Bull player is there to, you know, touch it again, where I think the Hurricanes, they're just not rotating back to front quite as fast as they need to. So if they pick up the speed here just a little bit and shore up those rotations, I think they'll be really competitive and can maybe steal a game away from the Bulls.
Oh, and Flom's with a great pass to Rainbow Noms there. Could have been a goal, but great defense coming from the Hurricanes. They're really fighting to stay alive in this one. They want to move on in the playoffs, but they've got an uphill battle. Let's see if they can do it. Is Flom's gonna send a shot off the bar? Really close to putting the Bulls up by one in this one.
Yeah, great flick. He was very patient. Final opportunity. Speaking of patience, I don't know if that was patience, more of just having the opportunity. Flams touches it to himself, turns on it. I think Peeves must have had ball cam off because he knew that the ball was coming. He was going to the corner for boost. Unfortunate, but Flams finds a way to put his team in front, and Hurricanes really have their back against the wall. Can't lose this one, and they find themselves down again.
Bulls on the cusp of a victory as that shot from Peeves going off the bar. That's got to be heartbreaking for him as the follow-up shot's going to go in from Flams, doubling their lead with a minute 49 remaining.
That's our first official feels bad man moment this game. Go ahead and throw that in the chat, because not send a ball off the post. That was a sure goal, in my opinion. But you get counterattack the other way, and now your job is doubly as hard, as you needed to score one in 2 minutes. Now you've got to score two against a team as dominant as the Bulls. That is going to be tough.
And really an uphill battle. Time not at all the friend of the Hurricanes right now, as Aguan trying to get it off the wall, struggling a little bit, and Rainbow Nom's going to be able to get that touch. Peeves trying to send it in. Flom's there with the clear in the side. But you really got to think, with a minute and 20 seconds remaining, that shot going just wide, but with a minute and 20 seconds remaining, the Hurricanes really have to pick up the pace offensively if they're going to have any hope of bringing it back in this one.
Yeah, nothing to lose here. If the scoreline gets a little worse, you know, you might expect them firing on all cylinders, throwing the kitchen sink at the Bulls just to try to find at least one goal here very quickly.
And this ball going to be picked up, sit down field. Flom's going to send it to Rainbow Nom, who, oh, just able to get there in time. Peeves not able to have the speed, and that's going to be almost the nail in the coffin. Still potentially enough time for the Hurricanes to come back, but Rainbow Nom's just made it a lot more difficult.
Yeah, the obvious downside about throwing everything that one. I would say we've seen three goals, even more than that, actually scored in 45 seconds. But by my count, the Hurricanes have only scored one goal this entire series. The Bulls have just been that good on defense. So I don't anticipate the Hurricanes being able to do this one. And I think the Bulls are just going to ride out this final 30 seconds and start preparing for the conference finals.
Peeves trying to get it on there. Follow up from McQuaid, going to go in. It's still possible, ladies and gentlemen. They could defy the odds, do the impossible, and try to come back in this one. It's still an insane uphill battle. But with 19 seconds, if they can get two kickoff goals, they could potentially push this game to overtime.
Yeah, can't count them out. Obviously, anything can happen. They are going to need one real quick, because you're going to obviously at least 1 second to score that last one.
10 seconds remaining. Ball gets sent to Peeves. Oh, it's going to go just wide. And that was the opportunity they desperately needed. It's all over for them now. The season comes to a crashing end for the Hurricanes. But the Bulls, taking the series in dominant fashion, going to be moving on to the conference finals.
Absolutely. Had that touch been on target for the Hurricanes, things would have got pretty interesting. But the Bulls five. That scoring chance, man, Bulls did everything right. Much like the Blizzard series and in the first series we saw on stream, Bulls just dominated both sides of the ball. Quick rotations to make great saves on defense, team plays to their teammates. Bulls looking very strong early in this playoffs.
And that series feeling like it flew by. I almost thought it just started, but we're already at the end of game three. The Bulls all series long just looked absolutely on top of the ball. Excellent team plays, excellent solo plays, air dribbles, sending it in, great defense. You couldn't have asked much more from them, and they kept the pressure up all series long, and it ends up paying off for them as they move to this conference finals. And you got to give it up to the Hurricanes, though. They really tried their best. They put their heart out there. It's got to feel bad to have a season in that way, but still a lot to be proud of from that series and a lot to be happy about with the season as a whole. But that's going to do it for this series. Don't any of you go anywhere, though. Plenty of Rocket League still to come as we move on into the night. Anything to say before we cut to break here, ZB?
No, just that there's a lot of great league action later. We have Foxes and Jets at 9 o'clock. Foxes, number one seed in the Blue Conference. And then Elite Tyrants. The winner of that game, the 10 o'clock game, is going to have to play these Bulls. So I know I'll be tuning in, that's for sure.
Absolutely. But thank you, everyone, for watching this Premier League match of the Hurricanes versus the Bulls. Remember, don't go anywhere. Still a lot to be here on Minor League Esports.